All right, I will say good morning. Let us begin. We are picking up today in Os Yud Dalit in Sivkas HaTzadik. So another beautiful concept by the Rebbe. So the Rebbe writes as follows: Gam bayom yesh pamim anonim hamonim ha'ar. So we'll say, so remember again, the Rebbe here is continuing on the metaphor from Os Yud Gimel, which is the, we'll call it the day-night metaphor. The idea being that just as in the natural world, there is light and there is darkness, and just as in the natural world, there is day and there is night, so too in the life of man, there are periods of accomplishment, periods of aliyah, and then there are periods of failure and descent. But the Rebbe here makes an amazing observation. He says, even during the day, in the natural world, even during the day, when the sun is out, the light is shining forth, he said, often there are clouds which prevent the light from fully coming through, right? So even in the midst of the yom, even in the midst of the ar, a beautiful luminescent day, the sky is bright, yet sometimes the sun can't be seen because it is obscured by the clouds. So what's the pshat? So if you take a look in the Uriya Chasidus, so let's explain a little bit more. He says, "Du'umas hamavor la'el shagam balayla shuz manach hashichus vahester nitzrach lios la'adam or halavana v'kochav v'ner mitzvah yispar kan shagam bayom shu bizman sheshem shamayim nigla apneir kol olam katan gam az nitzrach lios koach hamastir shagam hu noe l'tova." Just read one more line, then we'll translate. Ukimosh shebegashmius kam bayom shuz mana or yesh bechozos lefamim anonim hamonim umastirim es or shel Hashem mishmina olam. So
this is really incredible. So therefore, much of this, the Rebbe is explaining that we spoke about, if you remember again, that even in times of night, the night is never fully dark, because there's always the light of the moon and of the stars. And we described the metaphorical significance of those moons and stars in our previous shir. But the Rebbe explains so beautifully that even during the day, the light is not absolute. Even in the day, the clouds are there to block out the sun. Back up top, the clouds are there, and here's what's interesting, the clouds are there to go ahead and, the clouds are there to somehow diminish the intensity of the sun, yet they don't black out the sun. Right? They don't block out. They don't make the sky black. They don't make the sky dark. So they diminish the intensity of the sun, aval lo machshichim, but they do not go ahead and cause darkness to come about. V'heim l'tova. And the Rebbe said, these clouds are all for the good. These clouds are all for the good. So we'll say, why? Ki amistakel b'shemesh ein of chaos. Because everyone knows, if you look directly into the sun, your eyesight diminishes. Look directly into the sun, your eyesight diminishes. So we'll say, this is really, you could tell, even though we don't really know what the Rebbe is saying yet, you could tell we're on the cusp of saying something dramatically amazing. See, here you have Reb Tzaddik saying like this, even in the midst of the luminescent day, nevertheless, the sun must remain a bit obscured. So the clouds come along to go ahead and diminish the sun, but not to totally blot it out. Not to totally eclipse it. In other words, the light of the sun is still able to peek through, sometimes in different rays, sometimes, but yet the clouds are there to diminish it. And the diminution of the sun is actually a positive thing. Why? Because if you look directly into the sun, your eyesight can diminish. So what's the pshat? So I say, so take a look. Well, let's finish the section. He says, the gam lenoa tokef hachom hamazik pam la'adam. The other thing that clouds do is that sometimes clouds have the ability to diminish the heat of the sun. Sometimes the intensity of the sun is so much that the heat, that the brightness could go, the heat could really go ahead and be detrimental. Like we saw by Nadav and Avihu, that sometimes the intensity of the sun can be too much. So what's the pshat? What's happening over here? So take a look again at the Biuri HaChasidus. This is really incredible. He says, look in the right-hand paragraph, about three lines in. So the clouds really provide a benefit by obscuring the sun. Ki bihirus or hashemesh ina tova tamid, ubechomatzav lebriya seinayim. Because we'll say right subtzadik. Because at the end of the day, the light of the sun is not always good for a person, and the light of the sun is not always helpful, beneficial, or right or good ultimately for one's eyesight. Shahari hamistakel bashemesh, ena of chaos v'nechloshos. For if one looks directly into the sun, his eyes have the ability to become dim and weak. Va'otova yesh b'hatzlala v'hatzdarazu, shenoad agam nimnoa es tokef achom habokeh mikarni hashemesh amazipam la'adam. So again, so what the Rebbe is pointing out is that cloud cover really provides two benefits. Number one, if you look directly into the sun, it can hurt your eyesight. So the clouds diminish the intensity of the sun a little bit, thereby preserving one's eyesight. And furthermore, again, therefore the sun provides two benefits. The clouds provide two benefits. Number one, well, both of them are the same. They diminish the intensity of the sun. That benefit plays itself out in two ways. Number one, that if one looks into the clouds, one's eyesight is not harmed by the intensity of the sun. And the cloud sometimes has the ability to diminish the heat of the sun. And the heat of the sun, if too intense, can be detrimental to a person. Okay, very interesting. What's the pshat? What's the message? So look what Reb Tzadik says. Look at the Be'ori HaChasidus, page Lamed Dalid, on the right-hand column, about three lines up from the bottom. He says, Ukimokin hadvarim amurim gam biyachas lenefesh. What we're saying over here regarding the body is true for the... Remember again, this entire thing is a metaphor. So what's the metaphor? He says, Shebizman shemiskala or ha'emes li'adam, b'chozos lefamin, yesh tova umayla b'hastara chilek me'or ha'emes, habahir midai. And we'll say, get ready for this idea. And this is really incredible, and at first will even sound like a bit antithetical to everything we generally say. So the Rebbe says like this. Remember, what does the sun represent? The sun, daytime, light, represents Torah, represents spirituality, represents holiness, represents connection to God, represents all the beautiful and wonderful things we aspire to achieve and to acquire. The Rebbe says, sometimes you have to blunt your spirituality a little bit as well. Hear this out. Sometimes you have to diminish the intensity of the sun of spirituality a little bit as well. Because if the sun is too intense, it hurts the eyesight. If the sun is too intense, it could give you a sunburn. Right? The sun is too intense, it could actually be detrimental. At times, you need a little bit of cloud cover just in order to be able to properly have the right dosage of the sun. Because if not, kevon shemistakel yoser midayim, in the left-hand paragraph in Be'orei Chasidus, kevon shemistakel yoser midayim ba'ora emes abohir, yochol hadavar ligrom lahachlish es koach hasagas ha'emes. Because sometimes looking at the sun too directly actually has a negative repercussion, negative consequences. If you skip down a little bit, he says, "Vegam riboy hislavu shal isha avol Hashem yisparach hanovas measagas arivuso vaotzem sikus or the nefesh yochala hazik nefesh." So we'll say, so what's the example of this? What does this mean? Again, this almost is like sounds like a little bit spiritually offensive. We spend our lives speaking about the need to acquire more spirituality, to acquire more holiness. And now the Rebbe is saying, calm down. Now the Rebbe is saying, you know, sometimes you have to blunt the sun a little bit. Sometimes you need a little bit of cloud cover in order that your eyesight doesn't get harmed by staring into the sun, or that you don't get a sunburn by going ahead and spending too much time in the sun. Now I'm supposed to diminish spirituality, so blunt spirituality. And remember, what's the example he gives? The example he gives, you want to know people who spend too much time in the sun? Nadav and Aviu. Nadav and Aviu. What happened with Nadav and Aviu? So remember again, Nadav and Aviu, although the Pasuk says that they brought an Eshzar, they brought an alien fire, Nadav and Aviu are examples of individuals who got too carried away with spirituality. Their chet, their sin, came from the most noble of places, a desire to serve the Ribono Shel Olam. But the problem is that it was unchecked. It was without limitations. It was without a framework. And as such, again, led to detrimental, catastrophic circumstances. So what the Rebbe is teaching us, and we'll have to stop here for today, but we'll have to do with this thing tomorrow, is that spirituality requires boundaries. Spirituality requires boundaries. The sun requires the clouds, because the sun, as beautiful and as magnificent and as luminescent as it may be, sometimes if there's not a little bit of cloud cover, so if you try to stare into it, it'll harm your eyes. You spend too much time under it, you're going to get burned and harmed. We'll say this idea that spirituality requires a certain framework to keep it in check. And also we're going to see that this lesson manifests itself in a variety of ways. You know, sometimes it happens that people get so carried away with spirituality that they forget the need to be attentive with other things. How many times does it happen that a person is, quote-unquote, engaged in the service of God, yet they end up mistreating another person? It wasn't their intention. It wasn't their intention. I mean, my intention was to serve HaKadosh Baruch Hu, but I became so subsumed in my service of God that I forgot that I am also duty-bound towards the other, right? I became so consumed by the sun that I forgot that I have to be cognizant and careful with the feelings of someone else, that service of HaKadosh Baruch Hu is not a license to trample on other people. Or how many times does it happen that just we get so caught up in the service of HaKadosh Baruch Hu that we neglect other responsibilities that we may have? Or we go ahead and we tread lightly upon other, or we tread, not so lightly, upon other responsibilities that we may have. So again, we're going to define this more, but this is where the Rebbe says that even during the day, even the day which represents holiness, spirituality, connection to God, it's beneficial when there are some clouds in the sky, because the clouds are able to temper the intensity of the sun. In the acquisition of a spiritual identity, we must be careful that the sun does not cause harm to other areas of life and other areas of responsibility. Sometimes you have to take the light of spirituality and temper it with the cloud cover so that you could look into the heavens, that you don't get sunburned. Nadav and Avihu became so consumed by the luminescent beauty of the sun that they forgot about other significant details. And that forgetfulness, unfortunately, cost them their lives. So we'll stop over here for today. We'll pick up Emir HaTashem more with the cloud cover tomorrow. Shkoyach.